are in extraordinary times for many reasons, but today I simply want to focus on those around climate change. I'm going to issue you all a challenge today, and that is to rise to this extraordinary time with an extraordinary response, one on par with the very frankly existential crisis that we face, and that you all help lead the solutions that forests and forest landowners provide. This is the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, IPCC's projections on the suite of carbon emissions. Atmospheric concentration levels that follow that. You know that the first three curves are utterly unacceptable. That's the trajectory we're on, and it's utterly unacceptable. The fourth, which is the red line, is possibly acceptable. This may lead to a recognizable world for us, our children, and grandchildren. But only the fifth, the green line, is a safe path, and that is the one that we must follow. And 2 weeks ago, as Becky noted, the IPCC released its report on just how well we're doing towards achieving that safe green line. I want to share two quotes that in particular I found compelling out of this report. The first was from Jim Skia, who was co-chair of the Working Group 3 for the IPCC. Limiting warming to 1.5 degrees Celsius is within the laws of chemistry and physics. But doing so would require unprecedented changes. The second quote is from Deborah Roberts, co-chair of IPCC Working Group number 2. The decisions we make today are critical in ensuring a safe and sustainable world for everyone, both now and in the future. The next few years are probably the most important in our history. That's pretty sobering. Within the laws of chemistry and physics, the most important years in our human history. So as you all know, we've actually been exceeding the worst of these curves. We have been exceptional in the wrong direction. And essentially, I think we have 5 to 10 years to change the trajectory of these emissions. And if we do not, by 2030, we will pass the 1.5 degree mark. And by 2040, we will have irreversible and cataclysmic changes. Cataclysmic is not a word we use very often. The fires this summer may give you some sense of that. So we have 11 years and 21 years. How many of us will be alive in 11 years? How many of us have children or grandchildren who will be alive in 11 and 21 years? That's your time frame. And we want to make unprecedented changes, not just around the margins. Trees. We can change our trajectory, and that is identified by a third finding in the report, and that is what concerns us here today. We can reach that same green line by working with forests, and there is a very clear global consensus that we cannot reach it without working with. In fact, between the IPCC and Woods Hole, they'd say between 35 and 50% of that solution will come from forests and the land sector. And that we can start that now, we have very immediate returns we can achieve from that. Most importantly, the technology that we need to do that, we already have. And that is the technology that you in this room know well, which is how to manage forests and how to conserve forests. You are key to this solution. So today I'd like to make three primary points. We are in the midst of a burgeoning crisis. I love that word burgeoning. It means rapidly increasing. But if I said rapidly increasing, you'd go, yeah, rapidly increasing. Burgeoning. We have a burgeoning and indeed an existential crisis for the world as we know it. We need a response on par with the response that we gave to World War II, and we can do that. The second message is that forests are key to solving this crisis, and the next 5 to 10 years are determinative. Third is that Washington State has some of the single greatest opportunities on earth to make a difference and to pioneer the solutions and lead the way for others to follow. So fundamentally, we can and we must rise to this existential threat. We must reimagine and invest in forests for carbon-rich, climate-resilient forests, making that a reality through policy changes and market-driven changes to create a forest future. So there are three key solutions within the forest sector: reducing forest loss, restoring and maintaining carbon-rich, resilient, climate-resilient forests, reweaving a much more functional forest landscape, and replanting former forests where possible. Really simple, the three R's.